Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
This is Astro Chase for the Atari 5200 Super System, one of the many ports of arcade games to the home Atari 5200 platform. Now, the first thing you're going to notice here is the opening title screen, which at the time was pretty cool, you know, particularly for a home game. The 5200 version plays the 1812 overture music over and over and over and over and over. You pay a little pilot here, and he goes up to a little fly-in saucer to defend the Earth. Now, in case you haven't figured out this, I'm going to let you know right now, space is a really, really, really tough place. You just can't just fly off in this space. Everybody's shooting at you for no reason. They give you no warning. They're trying to invade Earth. There's all these invaders from space. They're trying to hurt you, and they want you dead. There's no fun out in space. Everybody's trying to kill you. And Astro Chase is another one of those games that proves it. Here you are in your little flying saucer spaceship, and you fly around the Earth, defending it. Now, on the four corners of a certain area is a shield area, and you can't go past that, so it's limited to where you can go. And inside the shield area, you have these bad guys that come at you, and they're just trying to shoot at you and kill you with no warning, nothing. But here's the problem. As these guys are coming and shooting at you, these mines, these mega mines, are floating around and they're going towards Earth. Well, those mines are coming towards Earth, and if one of them touches the Earth, it's over, man. Game over. What you're trying to do is you fly around, you're trying to take out the mega mines while the aliens are shooting at you. Now this, I never actually played this in the arcade. I actually played it on the 5200 first. It wasn't that popular of an arcade game, but you know, I thought it's an okay game. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with it. It's got a nice little universe going on there. It's almost like playing pinball in the sense that you can go bouncing back before these little planets. It's just, it's a little slow and it's really repetitive, and you do have other like secret weapons that you can use, like shields and so forth. And another neat thing is these intermissions. If you destroy all the mega mines in a level, you go to different levels, and after so many levels you get a hero's welcome. And here, game over, man, game over. So it does have the intermissions and has little animation like this, so if they get to the Earth, boom, it's over. I actually kind of like this game. It's kind of fun. It's a little slow moving and almost boring in that sense, but you can get used to it. It's actually a fairly fun game, and it's kind of original. It reminds me of a sense of 1941 or one of these type games where you're just going around and shooting at everything. Well, this has got obstacles and special weapons, and there's actually something that you're doing. You know, you're not just fighting aliens, you're trying to defend the Earth from being destroyed. So it is actually a fun little game that you might want to check out. I'm giving this game an A-. I really liked it a lot. I thought it was a good arcade port. The graphics are nice. The sounds are there. It's got music and animations and intermissions, and it's just a little boring for my taste, so I knock it down to a nice solid A-.